Hi friends, in this tutorial series, we'll be implementing examples for deploying Spring Boot applications using Kubernetes. In previous tutorial, we set up Minikube, which is a single node Kubernetes server. In this tutorial, we'll be going over the basics of Docker and also we'll be creating a Docker image for our Spring Boot application. For this, I'll be taking reference of my website javainews.com. So go to DevOps, Kubernetes tutorials. The example that we'll be implementing today is create Docker image for Spring Boot microservices. So in this tutorial, we'll be going over the Docker basics and also creating an image for Spring Boot microservice. In a previous tutorial, we had set up Minikube, which is a single node Kubernetes server. So here we have given the video, you can go through this. So in this tutorial, on the Ubuntu operating system, we had installed Minikube. Next, we'll be deploying the Spring Boot application using Minikube, which we installed previously. So the Spring Boot application, it will be running inside the Docker container, which will be managed by Minikube pods. So we'll be having the Minikube server, which will be having the pod, and the pod, it will be running the Docker container having the Spring Boot application. For Minikube to create the Spring Boot Docker container to be managed by pods, we need to provide Minikube with the Docker image of the Spring Boot application, which is to be deployed. So the Minikube server, it will need a Docker image of the Spring Boot application, which is going to be deployed inside the pod as a Docker container. To create this Docker image, we first need to create a Docker file. In this tutorial, we'll be going over the Docker basics and also we'll be creating the Spring Boot Docker image, which we'll then provide to Minikube for deployment. So let us begin with the implementation part. In previous tutorial, we had implemented examples for deploying Spring Boot applications to Docker. So yeah, you can go through this tutorial. In this tutorial, we had covered all the basics of Docker, like what are Docker images, what are Docker containers, what all are the different scenarios in which we'll be using Docker. Also, we had implemented a number of examples for Spring Boot and Docker. You can go through all these tutorials here. One of the examples that we had implemented before was deploying Spring-based jar application to Docker. So in this tutorial, we had created a Spring Boot microservice web application. We had created an image for this application and later we had run this image as a Docker container. So we'll again be implementing these steps for this tutorial. So this was the Spring Boot application that we were making use of. So go below and from here, download the Spring Boot application. The Spring Boot project that we just downloaded is a Maven project, so I have imported this in Eclipse. Next, run this as a Maven project, do Maven install. So this will build this project and it will create a jar file which will then be stored in the target folder. So yeah, this is the jar file that has been created for this project. In this project, we have written a controller where we are exposing a get rest endpoint with the URL slash employee and where we are going to return the employee details. So here we have some mock data. And this will be returned whenever someone hits the URL slash employee. For the Spring Boot project, we also created a Docker file. So a Docker file is a list of commands that we want the Docker engine to execute. So here, this is the Docker file that we have created for this Spring Boot project. So using this Docker file, if we create a Docker image and later run that Docker image as a container, then what will happen is that first OpenJDK, it will be downloaded from Docker Hub. So the Docker container that is running, it will have an OpenJDK 8 environment. Next, we'll be copying the employee producer jar file that gets created in the target folder to inside the Docker container. And finally, inside the Docker container, using the command java-jar, we'll be running the jar file that we have copied to Docker container. So using these three commands, the Spring Boot application, it will get deployed inside the Docker container. So the Spring Boot project that we have downloaded previously, it already has the Docker file. So these are the commands that we just went through. Next, using this Docker file, we'll be creating a Docker image for the Spring Boot project. For the Docker deployment, we'll be making use of the Ubuntu terminal that we had installed previously. So start the Ubuntu terminal. Use the command sudo su. Next, we'll go to the location where we have the Spring Boot project that we have downloaded. So we'll need to mount that location in this Ubuntu terminal. I have that project employee producer at this location. So I'll be doing cv slash mount. Then I'm using the D drive Docker code employee producer. I do ls. So here we'll be having the Docker file and also the target folder inside which we have the jar file. Next, we'll be creating the Docker image using the command docker image build hyphen t. This will be the name of the image that will be created. And dot, it will specify that it is the current working directory location. So copy this. So go to the Ubuntu terminal. So at this location, we have the Docker file. and this is a command which will be running. The dot again, it will be specify the current working directory where it expects the Docker file to be present. Press enter. So this will build a Docker image for us. Here it is downloading OpenJDK from Docker Hub. So here the Docker image, it has been created. If we now use the command docker image ls, yeah, we can see that the image, it has been created for us. Next, we'll be running this Docker image as a container. So for this, the command is docker container run hyphen hyphen name producer. So this will be the name of the container that will be created using this image, hyphen p 8080 colon 8080. So we'll be linking the port 8080 of the Docker container with the port 8080 of Ubuntu. So the inside the Docker container, the Spring Boot application, it will be running on port 8080, and then we can connect to this 8080 port using the 8080 port of Ubuntu. Hyphen d, the name of the image that we'll be using to create this container. So copy this command. So the Docker container, it has been created for us. We now use the command docker container ls. So here, using the image employee producer Kubernetes, a container name producer has been created and it is currently running. So let us test this. So if we now, yeah, we can check the logs using this. So here in the container logs, we can see that the Spring Boot application, it has started successfully. Next, we'll be testing the Spring Boot application deployed in Docker. So for that, we'll be using the curl command and we'll be hitting the URL localhost colon 8080 slash employee. So we have already linked the Ubuntu port 8080 with the Docker container port 8080 where the Spring Boot application is running. So let us see if we get a response. So here we are getting the response back. So it is returning us the employee detail. So it has been successfully deployed in the Docker container. Now that we have created the Docker image for the Spring Boot application, we'll see how we can pass the Docker image to Kubernetes. So the Docker image, it can be passed to Minikube in two ways. One is the local Docker image. So Minikube, it makes use of the locally created Docker image. So if we run the command docker image ls, we can see that the employee producer is a local image. So this image, it can be used by Minikube. Another way in which we can pass the image to Minikube is by making use of Docker Hub. So Minikube, instead of making use of the local image, it will get the image from Docker Hub. So Docker Hub, it is a central repository for Docker images. In previous Docker tutorials, we have already implemented examples of using Docker Hub. So yeah, in this tutorial, we have given the video. You can go through the basics of Docker Hub. You'll need to create an account for Docker Hub. I already have a Docker Hub account. So yeah, these are the images that are present in my Docker Hub account currently. So again, we have covered the basics of Docker Hub in this Docker tutorial. You can go through this. For this tutorial, we'll be pushing the Docker image that we just created to Docker Hub, and later on Minikube, it will be fetching the image from Docker Hub to get it deployed using pods. So let us begin the implementation part. So here I'll first need to log in to Docker Hub. So the command is docker login. So I have already entered my credentials here. So it will ask for the username and password which you'll have to enter. In my case, the username was Java in use. So here we have successfully logged in to Docker Hub. Next, we'll push the image to Docker Hub. So the command for this is docker image push and the name of the image. So here it is trying to push the image. Here it is giving an exception, requested access to the resources denied. We get this exception because only official Docker images can be in the above format with only the name. So here, while trying to push the image, we are only using the name of the image, but this is not allowed for us. Only official Docker images, they can have this format with only the name. For us, we should have the format owner slash docker image name. So in my case, the owner is Java in use, so it should be Java in use and then the name of the image. So we'll need to add the owner tag to the existing image that we have. So we'll be adding Java in use to employee producer Kubernetes image. For this, the command will be docker image tag, the name of the image to which we have to add the tag. So copy this. If we now do docker image ls, so here we have the employee producer Kubernetes image. If we now use this docker image tag command, again to docker image ls. So now we have one more image, and for this a tag has been added. If you'll see, the image ID of both the images are the same, only we have added a tag to this employee producer Kubernetes image. Next, we'll be pushing this image with the account name to Docker Hub. So for this, the command will be docker image push and the name of the image. So it is trying to upload the image to Docker Hub. So here it is showing that it has successfully pushed the image to Docker Hub. If you now to go to Docker Hub and refresh this page, so here we can see that the image, it has been successfully uploaded to Docker Hub. In the next tutorial, we'll be making use of both the local image as well as this Docker Hub image for deploying the Spring Boot application to Minikube.